today I have a hypnotherapy session with Kelly, and the last time I saw her it went really well.
Hello, hello.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good.
It's really important that I stop this yo-yo cycle because in order to get the surgery, I need to not only lose the 30 pounds, but I need to maintain my weight after that.
So now I'm 10 pounds down from what I need to get my surgery. So I'm 1/3 of the way there.
How do you feel about that?
That's good.
That's good.
I just need to lose another 20 more pounds.
That's good.
Which is a lot, but...
All right, so today we're gonna switch up a bit, so... We're doing some past life regression.
I'm just a little bit confused. So we're gonna go into my past life's life, multiple lives or just one life?
You've probably had many, many, many past lives. This is probably one of the deeper levels of hypnosis that a person can experience.
I'm open to past life regression because I believe that I've had past lives and maybe it could unlock the doors of my mind or my past.
So we're gonna go revisit a past life that's gonna evaluate and offer healing to your binge eating in this lifetime. Now, with that intention, that will dictate which lifetime we go into. And you're just going to observe. What's your role, as I always say?
Relax, observe, and report.
And that's what you're gonna do in this process.
Okay.
I'm hoping that in today's session, we find out why I binge eat, and hopefully by figuring out that problem, I could lose the weight and keep it off.
Take a deep cleansing breath in. And as you very slowly exhale, relax. I'm hopeful that we can connect some dots as far as what her past life experiences have been and how it impacts this lifetime. So look up into the sky and see if you can find a big, white, fluffy cloud. So I'm asking that cloud to move and carry you back into time and space. And I want you to tell me the very first thing that you see or that you notice.
I'm in like a town center.
Mm-hmm.
People are selling food. It's like a market.
Okay. What are you feeling or sensing being here?
Hungry.
You're hungry. What's your name?
Cal.
Cal. Okay. What are you doing in this marketplace? Do you sense that you live nearby?
I don't have a home.
You don't? Okay.
I don't think my family wants me.
Why? What happened?
I'm gay.
You're gay. Okay.
They caught me with a guy.
And what happened?
They kicked me out.
Kicked you out. How did that make you feel?
Rejected. My dream was to hold his hand in this market. Now I'm just alone in the market. And I'm hungry. I haven't eaten.
Okay. Just allow that to come up. I'm right here with you. So we're gonna leave this scene and we're gonna drift and float forward to the last day of Cal's life. You're drifting and floating, floating and drifting, and you're there now. And what's happening?
I'm sitting on a rocking chair.
Mm-hmm.
I was never able to live the life that I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to do this.
You don't want to do what?
I don't want to live anymore.
You don't want to?
Mm-mm.
So what was he hungry for that day in the market?
He was hungry to be accepted.
Mm-hmm. He was. What advice do you have for Jazz that can help her? What's she hungry for?
She's still hungry to be accepted.
What advice can you give her? You have perspective of all. What can you tell her?
She's just got a little mixed up. That is what happens with emotions. We get mixed up. That's okay. That's okay.
And now your spirit, you have full perspective of everything about that lifetime. And when you're ready, and only when you're ready, Jazz, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Back to your regular waking consciousness, feeling good, feeling well rested, feeling wonderful all over.
Coming out of the hypnosis, it feels like I traveled through another lifetime. I was definitely able to connect a few dots from my past life to my current life because there were a lot of underlying themes that are relevant to what I'm going through now.
Welcome back. You did that phenomenally. How do you feel coming out of that as far as your perspective now about yourself? And the analogy of being hungry for food, but also hungry for something else in that marketplace.
It was just acceptance. And I know here in this world, not everyone accepts all your choices, whether that be your family, someone you've never met before. And sometimes I feel selfish
for making
decisions, you know, that make me happy, but it's not selfish.
It's not selfish. Jazz puts a lot of pressure on herself. And I think that her being able to experience that past life allowed her to connect the binge eating and her needing and wanting acceptance. Cal sacrificed his whole life, right?
Yeah.
For acceptance.
And he couldn't be himself. It's like, now I'm making up for, you know, that past life where I wasn't able to be myself. And that kind of makes sense.
I share a lot of similarities with Cal because he was looking for that acceptance but faced intolerance. And I have faced a lot of those struggles as well. And I try to stay strong, like I always seem like this mighty person who has no problems and who is not vulnerable at all. But I binge eat to make myself feel happier. And I feel like I finally understand why that is.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I finally feel empowered to gain back control over my life.
All right.
It was wonderful.
Yay.